The Democratic National Convention is on in the US, and just before it began, Democratic presidential candidate Hillary Clinton announced her vice presidential running mate, Tim Kaine. See, Tim Kaine isn't the most exciting VP pick. Not when the other options were Senator Cory Booker, who would have been the first African-American VP nominee, or Senator Elizabeth Warren, who would have made this a two-woman ticket. Sure, there were questions about whether America was ready for that, because two people of the same gender have never been running mates before every single election. But imagine the possibilities. But look, the Clinton-Kaine ticket isn't all that bad, actually. One, Kaine isn't a very showy politician, which means he won't overshadow Clinton at a time when the focus really needs to be on her and less on other things like leaked emails and such. Two, Kaine spent a year in Honduras and is fluent in Spanish, which will appeal to the Hispanic vote bank. Three, he's been a mayor, governor, and a US senator. There's no question about experience. Four, he's a white Catholic male and he's bound to assuage fears among the more conservative base that Clinton won't move further left. Five, he was one of Barack Obama's top VP choices in 2008. In fact, the White House has endorsed him as Clinton's running mate. Plus, he's a friend of India. And that's always a good thing, isn't it? Indian Americans in the US seem quite pleased at Clinton's choice. Kaine's also an active member of the Senate India Caucus, of which Clinton is the founding member and first co-chair. Kaine's been to India multiple times, and his home state of Virginia is among the top 10 US states with the largest Indian origin population. So he's been courting that demographic for a while now. After Prime Minister Modi's address in Congress in June this year, Kaine felicitated him, but also pointed out that he hopes the PM continues efforts to better protect the inalienable rights afforded to all people, just as we, as in the USA, fight against expressions of religious intolerance in our own political climate. So he's not afraid to point out his concerns either. If the Clinton-Kaine duo wins, India may have a lot to gain.